Okay, we got off the plane a couple of hours ago. We're in Cairns. We can't find anywhere to stay. Can't afford anywhere to stay, so we're having to camp instead.
Three of us have been making the film Fatigue over the past 4 years. It's a very low budget feature film and we're here to try and sell it.
Over the next 5 days we're going to try and take on the big film distribution companies here at the Cairns Film Festival. Our selling tool is a 90 second trailer.
May 2000, the 53rd Cannes Film Festival, a fantastic place to be. And for three young filmmakers from Cardiff, the only place to be.
Sun is shining, the weather.
How do you do? Do you like my nail?
No Welsh film has ever won the Palme d'Or. No Welsh film has ever been selected for competition. With over 6,000 participants and 2,000 films, do these boys from Cardiff stand any chance of making an impact with their 15 grand movie? Want you to know
I'm a rainbow. The first night in the tents, it's a bit of a nightmare really.
Actually, sleep-wise it wasn't too bad, but in the morning the police shifted us on. Meeting Emil was a bit of a godsend, to be honest.
We were just walking through the town and Mike just suddenly ran off and there was Emil across the road.
We'd have been in the shit, I think, trying to lumber that amount of equipment around and on a campsite. You just wouldn't have felt safe leaving it there. We'd have had to get some secure room, but again, speaking the language and doing all that sort of thing, it would have been really, really difficult. So that was a real stroke of luck.
All right, nice to have you here.
So we're going to register today, are we?
We've got to register today, haven't we? So. Yeah.
Register, that's the first thing.
Day one starts with queuing.
We don't know actually what we're queuing for, whether this is registration for the market, which is what we want, or whether it's registration for the festival, for passes for the films. So we're all queuing like a bunch of sheep.
Okay, this is a bit of a nightmare, and I think that's going to be the day, that's going to be like that all day, so it's only the beginning of the problems.
This should, hopefully, be the last queue of the day.
Yeah. It's not as glamorous as I thought it would be. It's
not a dole office. A dole office, you've even got numbers like
Tesco. Yeah, you've got no cheese ticket.
Better the dole office than this, you know? This is supposed to be Cannes Film Festival. We're paying 500 quid for the privilege. I haven't even got a thing with numbers.
Haven't got anywhere we can sit down. It's outrageous.
8 quid. I've got 200 down between us.
That's the money gone. Just waiting for the cards.
Oh, thank you.
What's going on? Sorted.
We each got one of these. But we still can't see any films with this.
The strange thing is we were first in the queue here this morning.
Yeah, it's grand,
but we didn't have all the paperwork. It's taken us 5 hours to get the paperwork.
Well, I'm not convinced we haven't just paid 500 quid for a pass that we're going to get now for free.
Yeah.
And that'll get us into the market and film.
Yeah, this won't let you in the market. Market only.
What was that we were just in?
But even though we just walked in the market now.
No, we didn't walk in the market.
That wasn't the market.
Well, it was, I think it's a mythique.
Oh, I see.
A mythique.
Which is. I need the other card.
We need that one.
Well, we've just achieved these. We have to take them somewhere else, but these basically will allow us to get festival tickets so we can actually see films.
Right.
So, for the whole 14 days.
Alright.
I think we should go and eat now, because I'm f***ed.
The opening ceremony. The boys go to watch and dream of walking on that red carpet.
One day soon.
You'll be hoovering a carpet.
Yeah, that's it. I'll be there.
I just think we might be able to get a bit closer with these things. On there.
Yeah. Oi, Mark! How'd you
get? I just walked up there and they seem to be gating everyone else off now, so I don't know if this means we're here, but everyone's in tuxes apart from us, which is a little bit worrying, but I don't know. We might as well wait here now just to see what happens.
We're standing on someone else's press plot and they might come and claim it, but hopefully it'll be okay.
Hello, we're touched to that red carpet.
En fait, on attend que si quelqu'un veut la place Q, que, parce que s'il y a eu une double commande en fait.
It says we need a reservation. You have to book between 10 and 12.
Oh, we need
and I say
that.
We don't have it.
Okay. Well, what I was saying earlier about the number and the pass, the officials just come up and asked us for our reservation.
Right, we're just on the red carpet getting some nice little shots. I don't know how we managed to blag our way up there, but we managed to do it somehow. These passes, brilliant. Getting the shots, got a few nice little glamorous shots, and then the bloke hoofed us off, but to be honest, it was getting a bit boring and the rain really started coming down once they kicked us off. So it's karma. So that's that.
Morning. I bought these mobile phones just to use here in Canberra. Right. And we can't use them. They're not picking up any signal, they're not connected at all. So basically we've got no communication.
And also the website doesn't seem to be working either, which is on here.
So we're having a techno
nightmare, yeah.
Okay, well this is the fatigue publicity campaign and it consists of 3,000 flyers which cost us about £180 and 100 VHS tapes which Marky nicked from a building site. So we've done alright there. We're not quite on the same league as Miramax yet, but maybe next year.
Hey!
Check it.
Today we're going to go to the market and try and find the companies that would be interested in watching this sort of genre, and hopefully they'll want to see the film.
What we've done this morning is gone through this. It's got a list of all the companies in, all the companies there, and then this shows which table they're at or whatever it is, little room. And so we're going to go around and the ones we've ticked off, give them a copy of the video, and try and just have a quick chat with them and see if they're interested in maybe speaking to us.
In the market, the glamour of the film festival disappears and the reality of the hard sell kicks in.
Well, we got one pretty similar, Gruffudd. Kind of, these mobster guys, they're hitmen, and then after they kill people, they chop them up.
Okay, great. So is there any time that we should come back? Well, your name?
Ray Guthrie. Ray.
Mike.
I'm Kate.
A lot of these channels are just buying for video release, and we're hoping to get a cinema release. So that's the only worry, that I don't think we're going to sign anything, you know, because it's just too dodgy.
Heard rumours that Barry Norman's inside British Pavilion, so we're just going to pop in there and see if we can arrange the interview and have a chat with him.
Would you have any advice for us? This is our first feature film, we've come to Cannes. It's quite overwhelming. We're not sure who we should be approaching, who we shouldn't be approaching. Would you have any knowledge of who we might?
In a word, no. I mean, I've never been in the position of trying to sell a film or set up a film down here.
although I've met several people over the years like you of trying to do it, and they all have the same problems. It is, I don't know, I think you just to an extent you've got to go by instinct, and getting in to see people who might offer you some money is a big enough task in itself, as you well know. And I think once you're there, do you sign something or not? I think, do you trust the person you're talking to is the big question. And if you do, then maybe it's good. This is the time to make the deal. If you don't, this is certainly not the time to make the deal, because you can get screwed down here very badly. I mean, the film industry is full of people who will screw you rigid, and you've got to watch out for them. The water is full of sharks.
Look at that.
What is that bit for? I'm absolutely exhausted, and I have to say, for the first time, I'm feeling a little bit depressed, because I thought we might be able to compete a little bit, but because we don't have Armani suits, because our publicity campaign consists of tiny little flyers and 100 VHS cassettes. It's all, it's a little bit pathetic, and it's a little bit of it's a joke. And for us, it's not really a joke. For me, it's not a joke anyway, because I've spent four years of my life making this film.
Welsh actor over there, Ioan Gruffudd, guy who's in Titanic and the former gamer.
He's a
big star. Yeah, big star. So I'm going to go up and give him a copy of the trailer, see if he's up for that.
Seems to be a focus.
Excuse me, Ioan.
We're doing an interview here?
Yeah, it's alright, just 2 minutes here time. Right. We made a real low budget feature film, we're trying to sell it around Cannes. There's a copy of the trailer there.
Right.
You can take that, watch it. And I don't know if we're in Cardiff, there's members there.
Are you Welsh, you?
Well, we've been in Cardiff for the last 10 years, it's all shot in Cardiff.
Right.
So, yeah.
What's your name?
I'm Mark.
Mark, Ioan. Yeah. Pleased to meet you.
I'm a producer and actor and
Knows what.
This is Mike.
Hi, Mike. Pleased to meet you. All right. How are things?
That's Chris on the camera.
Are you Chris?
Hello, mate.
Sorry,
thanks
for that.
So it's just, if you'd watch it and maybe give us some feedback, and if you know anyone you think might, because we're trying to get distribution.
Right.
Ideally, we could fit you in a wee scene.
There's a small part that's available.
There's a part for me, is there? That's the first offer I've had in Cannes. Brilliant. But the public
wanna show. 5 days into the festival, the boys are disillusioned with the market. They decide a new plan of attack: to try and set up meetings with the big film companies based in the hotels. Anyone who's anyone, from Universal to Warner Brothers, from Julia Roberts to George Clooney, has a suite in one of the hotels along the seafront. The boys decide to flyer every room in every hotel.
They bought it. They looked at it, seemed quite interesting, but it could be a little bit too hardcore for them.
Interesting one, he seemed to quite like it. Definite money man, that geese. He's not saying I take 25% if we distribute this and all that sort of thing. So.
They don't want it because they have too much to carry, so they give me a card instead.
Did you get
another
deal?
Yeah, another deal. If dealed in cards, we'd be millionaires. Yeah.
We've just been up to see Victor Films, but Vic Bateman wasn't in. That's the top floor, and then there's Alliance on the fourth floor, so we went in there and we couldn't actually speak to anyone in person. But we gave the video and gave a business card, a similar sort of scenario to the market, but we're just thinking we need someone in a suit, looks a bit more, you know, business-like than
the shark, the pen pusher,
someone who's not us, basically.
Yeah,
because you put the even when you put the trailer on, it's us in the trailer, so it loses credibility.
Let's put some on the phone box.
Seeking words of advice and encouragement, the trio ask for a meeting with the masters of low-budget filmmaking.
Bonjour, trauma.
Hello.
Hello, this is Mike McGuire.
Hi. Can I speak to Scott McKinley?
Sure, can I ask you who's calling?
It's Chris Dawson from Fatigue Films.
Just 1 minute, Chris. Yeah, maybe you could come by the... Can you come by the Carlton and see Mike Dwyer or myself?
Okay.
A gentleman named Mike or myself, and just, you know, tell him your name and that you're from the company there, and we'll hook you up.
Heidi is one of the stars, is the star of Citizen Taxi.
Hi, D.
Cool.
Hi, D. That's funny.
That's right. Alrighty, so what, Doug, what do we do now?
Come in.
You know, Troma is the oldest independent movie studio in the world, and the reason for that is the wonderful Toxic Avenger and the beautiful Heidi, who's playing Sarah, and look who's here, Dolphin Man, and Nicole is one of the stars of Citizen Taxi. Look at Nicole, look at the beautiful fashion.
Troma! Troma! Troma!
The key is that you do what's in your heart, you do what you believe in, and you don't care what people think. You don't care if people take you seriously. And who's ever making a low-budget film, do it. Just do it if you believe in it. Do what you believe in it. But don't do something with Julia Roberts because she's going to make you money. It's shite.
Most people are not allowed to see such excitement with their clothes on.
This is a talk about all the love you can. Oh my. This is excellent.
That's it.
That is beautiful. Oh my gosh.
Low-key fatigued. Wow. Very low-key.
Nice.
Cobble them together the night before.
Well, you know, when we are not sitting around making our own movies for Troma or doing movies like Terra Firma and Citizen Taxi, you know, we like to watch fatigue films. That's what we do.
You've got to admire them totally, actually, because they've been going 25 years and they're still going strong now. They're still doing films that they want to do. You've got to have total respect for that.
Okay, we've sneaked into one of the top hotels on the croissant here in Cannes. And if you're looking round that way, there's a party, exclusive party.
A bit later on, we'll do a few flyers in this place, and then we'll try and get in there, but I have my doubts whether we'll get in.
Yeah, give it a go, it's worth it. I know it looks like a real crush thing, but for some strange reason, you need to get in there. Before they got back though, I'd have been in there. So I might try it again, or we could or give it a go.
Well, we've got to get the flyers out. We've got to get them out. I haven't recognised anyone in here, mind. I think this is just a nobody's do.
This is what your can must be all about. Expensive parties. Shite.
The parties were poor. I suppose when you're there, you're supposed to network. I'm hopeless at that sort of crap, and I think the rest of the boys are as well, because we're just not bum lickers.
That's mine, I think.
No, that's mine.
No, that's yours.
Cheers. The Blair Witch press conference, a film made on a similar budget to Fatigue, and it's grossed over 400 million worldwide. Mark's frustration leads to a more direct approach.
Luckily, I had a copy of the trailer on me, and I just stuck up my mitt and said,
hey, we've been making this film. I can't remember what I said, but anyway. Hopefully they will actually watch it. I gave one of those sort of big-wiggy dudes a copy as well, and I said, oh, you might not watch it. And he goes, hey, that's how I discovered these guys. So, yeah, so maybe it'll work. We will find out.
Okay, so this is our last meeting. It's with Pathé. We've managed to get hold of them in the end. They're the guys that did the distribution for Blair Witch and stuff. So we're hoping they'll be a bit more open-minded about a low-budget film. But this is it. This is where it all dries up, really. We've done everything we can do while we're here. So I'm just going to go and be as polite as I can, really. I hope she likes it. Right, I've got to go because the time's...
Okay, good luck.
I had this sort of really optimistic dream that someone would see it, or they're trying to say, wow, that's brilliant, I'll invest millions of pounds in your next production, and to get this one into cinemas, I mean, that would have been lovely, but I guess that was a bit sort of Disneyland stuff, really.
I'm not disappointed that we've not sold it, because I don't think you would sell it here, unless you're being ripped off.
I think it would be nice to come here next year with the film and put it into the actual festival as a film that people could go and see, rather than try and sell it at the market, because I think we do a lot better by doing it that way. But you have to, I mean, we had to come here to learn that. It ain't no joke, I like to buy the world a token, teach the world to sing in perfect harmony, and teach the world to snuff the fires and the liars. Hey, I know it's just a song, but it's fast for the recipe. This is a love attack, I know when our body's back, it's just like it. If you got the goods, they'll come and buy it just to stay in the click. So don't delay, act now, supplies are running out. Allow if you're still alive, 6 to 8 years to arrive. And if you follow them, may be out tomorrow. But if the offers shine, you might as well be walking on the sun.
Okay, Chris, what have we just seen?
I don't know, I was asleep.
That was the most boring piece of shit I have ever seen.
A bit disappointing. Time to go.
Yeah, definitely be worth coming again, but I'd like to come, if you had a filming competition, that'd be superb. Or if you had even a film showing at the main place, that'd be really good. Obviously that'd be a bit of a dream.
How long is the trailer?
90 seconds.
90 seconds is good.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, Ioan?
Yes.
Sorry about that.
No.
It crashes. It's Cannes, isn't it?
Yeah.